A busy intersection in Fishers is now going to have to wait even longer for a big makeover. The roundabout and bridge project at State Road 37 and 144th Street is being delayed indefinitely because of high construction costs. Fishers engineers expected the cost for the work to be around $26 million. The lowest bid was more than $36 million. Fishers says they'll keep an eye on markets to decide when the right time is to start construction. Meanwhile, engineers expect traffic going through the intersection will drop off a bit once the other intersections just down State Road 37 fully reopen this fall. Some game-changing technology for electric cars is now being developed right here in Indiana. Researchers at Purdue are designing pavement that can charge an electric vehicle as it drives on it. Our Mike Sullivan shows you how it works.
The future always feels so distant until it pulls up next to you.
It's probably only a 15 to 20 year for a true normal.
Imagine a roadway so advanced it can charge an electric car, similar to the wireless charger on a nightstand.
The same idea, the more challenging problem is the higher power level.
The man in the monitor is Steve Pekarik, a Purdue professor researching the new tech.
The technology we're exploring is to put electric motors or coils within the pavement,
sending a charge to the battery, allowing it to run for stretches without burning energy.
And so its primary focus is to provide the power to the wheels of the vehicle so that you can reduce your battery size.
A smaller battery needs more affordable electric cars, less fear of losing power.
Key roadways would have it embedded within it.
Researchers right now,
we can observe over here,
are testing the pavement structure. This machine can simulate 40 to 50 years of wear in months.
No matter how effective the electricity underneath is, if you don't have a structural effective pavement that surrounds it, it's gonna fail.
Most roads are uniform underneath, yet with their roads,
approximately 2 to 3 inches underneath, there's what we call a charging unit,
which could reduce stability without proper design.
Or worse, that the road fails and it crashes all the components.
Next year, they plan to implement the tech on a quarter mile stretch in the state.
Our goal is to transition it to larger sections of roadway.
Like we said, the future is pulling up beside us. In West Lafayette, I'm Mike Sullivan, Fox 59 News.
The future is here. Researchers at Purdue are partnering with NDOT to get the technology on Indiana roads. Right now, NDOT is trying to decide which section of road they'll use the technology on first.